Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the section 2.4. In this section we will see some conditions for saying that we have a unique solution for linear or nonlinear first order differential equations. For existence and uniqueness of solutions of these equations, we need to look at two fundamental questions. The first question is that does every initial value problem have exactly one solution? The second is that if a solution exists, then is it unique? Without solving the differential equation, can we find the answer of these questions? Namely, can we understand whether we have exactly one solution for a differential equation for initial value problem, linear or nonlinear first order differential equations? So these questions are answered by the theorems written here. We have two theorems in this section. The first one is valid for linear first order differential equations with the initial condition. If the functions P and G are continuous and open interval from alpha to beta containing the initial value of the parameter t, which is t0, then there exists a unique function y is equal to phi of t that satisfies the differential equation y prime plus p of t times y is equal to g of t for each t in the interval from alpha to beta. We have an open interval from alpha to beta, and in this interval we have a solution, a unique solution for the linear differential equation written here with the initial condition yt0 is equal to y0, namely t0 is in the interval. Okay, so what is the condition to say that we have a unique solution? Just we will check whether the functions P and G are continuous on this interval, okay? And when we consider nonlinear differential first order differential equations, we must replace this theorem by a more general theorem like this one. Let the functions little f and its partial derivative with respect to y be continuous in some rectangle from alpha to beta and from gamma to delta for the variable y, since little f is a function of two variables t and y, with the initial condition yt0 is equal to y0 again, and this rectangle contains the initial point t0 y0 from here. Since we have a function of two variables, the region should be for defining these functions. A region should be, and this region is a rectangle, okay, like this one, from alpha to beta and from gamma to delta. So from here we have a rectangle. If we combine these points, and we should determine such a rectangle such that the functions little f and its partial derivative with respect to y are continuous. Okay, then in some interval, which is a sub interval of the interval from alpha to beta for the variable t, because t is actually the variable of the independent variable of the solution, you see. So we determine a sub interval, okay, and t0 is the interval, you know, t0 minus h, t0 plus h. T0 plus h. In this interval contained the interval from alpha to beta, namely we take a sub-interval containing the initial point t0, that then we say that there is a unique solution of the initial value problem y prime is equal to f of ty with the initial condition y of t0 is equal to y0. The most general form of first order differential equation will be in this form, if you remember. And if you have a nonlinear differential equation, so to determine whether there is a unique solution or not, we should check whether the functions f and its partial derivative with respect to y are continuous in some rectangles like this one. And then we take a sub-interval of the interval from alpha to beta such that the solution will exist in this interval. For example, use the first theorem to find an interval in which the initial value problem written here has a unique solution. First, we should check whether the given initial value problem satisfies the general form of the linear equation. So here we have the variable t for in front of y prime, but here we don't have any term. Therefore, to get rid of t, we should divide this equation by t to get just y prime. So after this, we have y prime plus 2 over t times y is equal to 4 times t. After dividing this equation by t, we get this one. And now we can determine the functions p and g. Here p is 2 over t by looking at the general form of the linear first order differential equation. And g of t 4 times t. Okay, so we should determine the continuity intervals for them. P of t is continuous everywhere except t is equal to 0, you see easily. The second one is continuous everywhere. We don't have any undefined point for g, so we can say both of them are continuous from minus infinity to zero, union from zero to plus infinity. Okay. Therefore, we say that the initial value problem has a unique solution on the interval from 0 to plus infinity. We take the second interval because when we look at the initial point, t0 is equal to 1. 1 is contained in the interval from 0 to plus infinity. Therefore, we remove this one and we say that the solution exists and we have a unique solution on the interval from 0 to infinity. And using the method of integrating factor, you can easily find the solution of this initial value problem, which will be y is equal to t square plus 1 over t square, where t is a positive real number. Okay, because it is, we have a unique solution on this interval, which includes the positive real numbers. So let's apply the second theorem to the initial value problem. Y prime is equal to 3x squared plus 4x plus 2 over 2 times y minus 1 with the initial condition y of 0 is equal to minus 1. So you see easily this is a nonlinear first order differential equation because it is not in the form of the linear differential equation written here, y prime plus p of t times y is equal to g of t. Instead of t, here we have x for the independent variable, and y is in the denominator. Therefore, this is not in the form written here. This is not in the form written here. Y should be in the numerator, and in front of y we have to have a function of independent variable. But here we don't have for the variable y. Therefore, it is nonlinear differential equation. Therefore, the first theorem is not applicable. To apply the second theorem, we observe that first we should determine the right-hand side of this nonlinear differential equation, which is a function of two variables. So we see f of xy is equal to 3x squared plus 4x plus 2 over 2 times y minus 1. And its partial derivative, because we should find some rectangle such that the functions f and its partial derivative have to be continuous there. So its partial derivative can be easily found if you remember the calculus 2, multivariable functions. We consider the variable x as a constant when we take the partial derivative of the function with respect to y, and we use the division rule to find the derivative. After that we will have this one, okay, and then we say these functions are continuous everywhere except on the line y is equal to 1, because when we write 1 for y we get 0 for the denominators, which means the functions are not defined here, therefore they are not continuous here. So we say that they are continuous everywhere. They are continuous everywhere. Except the line y is equal to 1. And the initial point, when we look at here, initial point has the component 0 and minus 1. 0 minus 1 should be there. So since the functions are continuous everywhere except this line, so we can sketch some rectangle containing this point. For example, can be in this form. Okay, it contains this point, and the functions are continuous on this rectangle. Therefore, from the theorem, we say that there is a unique solution of the initial value problem, and we can determine some interval about x is equal to 0 since the first component is 0 for the initial point, and the solution is defined in this interval. Okay. So after determining some rectangles, we can take an interval in this rectangle on the axis, which represents the independent variable of the solution. For example, this interval, such that we have a solution, a unique solution defined in this interval according to the second theorem. Another example: determine without solving the problem an interval, namely determine an interval without solving the problem in which the linear initial value problem written here is certain to exist. Namely, do we have a unique solution for this differential equation with the initial condition? So we can understand easily this is a linear function, because when we should find just y prime, but here we have a product of two terms. To get rid of this product, we will divide this equation by this one. Therefore, we find y prime plus 1 over t times t minus 4 times y is equal to 0, and this is of the form written here. P of we have y prime plus p of ty is equal to g of t. Therefore, it is a linear first order differential equation. Therefore, we use the first theorem to determine whether we have an interval in which the linear function is certain to exist. G of t is 0 from here, and p of t is equal to 1 over t times t minus 4. So the first one is continuous for any real number of for t, namely it is continuous everywhere since it is a constant function. The second one is continuous for all real numbers except the numbers 0 and 4, since when we write 0 or 4 for t, we get 0 for the denominator, which means the function is not defined. Therefore, possible regions will be from 0 to infinity, from minus infinity to 0, 0 to 4, 4 to plus infinity. Okay, we divide the set of real numbers into three sub intervals by using the undefined numbers 0 and 4. Therefore, we have three possible region, three possible intervals in which the initial value problem is certain to exist. So when we look at the initial condition of the problem, we say that our initial has t is equal to 0, namely t0 is equal to 2, we should pick a region which t is equal to 2 is inside. Then 0 to 4 is the open interval that our initial value problem has a unique solution. So while using the theorem, we say that we have a unique solution for the differential equation without solving the problem, and also we determine the open interval in which the solution is defined, okay, without solving the problem by using the first theorem. Another example, solve the initial value problem y prime is equal to y square with the initial condition y of 0 is equal to 1, and determine the interval in which the solution exists. So when we look at the type of the differential equation, it is a nonlinear differential equation because we have y square, and if you remember the form, the general form of the linear differential equations, we don't have any power of y except 1. Therefore, we have a nonlinear first order differential equation. There we use the second theorem because of this. So we should find f of ty according to the second theorem. This is the right hand side of the general form of first order differential equations, which is y square. And according to the theorem also, we should find its partial derivative with respect to y, which is equal to 2 times y. And they are continuous everywhere, every region in the two-dimensional coordinate system. Therefore, we can determine any interval for the parameter t such that the solution exists. And easily also we can find the solution by using the method of separation of variables, because we have separable variables for the differential equation by writing dy over dt is equal to y square. From here we have 1 over y square dy is equal to dt. Taking the integral of both sides of this equation, we obtain minus 1 over y is equal to t plus c, and t plus c. From here we have y is equal to y is equal to minus 1 over t plus c. And we have the initial condition, writing 0 for t and 1 for y, we get, let's continue here, 1 is equal to minus 1 over c, so c is equal to minus 1, c is equal to minus 1, writing this one, so we obtain y is equal to minus 1 over t minus 1, or we can write 1 over 1 minus t, 1 over 1 minus t. So after finding the solution, we see that it becomes unbounded as t goes to number 1. Therefore, the solution exists only in the interval from minus infinity to 1, since it contains the initial value of t, which is 0. Okay? Because at the number 1, the function is not defined. Therefore, we have two possible intervals from minus infinity to 1 and from 1 to plus infinity. So we can say the solution, there is a unique solution in the interval from minus infinity to number 1. Thank you very much.